The Denver Museum of Nature and Science is getting set to host up to 10,000 people for the 4th annual Girls in Science this Saturday. CBS 4 is proud to come together with the museum to encourage girls all across Colorado to get into science. Ashton is back in Colorado's Weather Center now. And Ashton, Girls in Science offers girls the opportunity to actually work on experiments alongside real life scientists. So this is certainly like a hands-on experience.
Yeah, that's right. And I've got one of those real life scientists here with me. The goal of Girls in Science is to encourage girls to consider careers in the STEM fields, science, technology, engineering, and math. And that's why I have Carmen Bernito Sanchez with me. She's an engineer with the Santec company. Carmen, thanks so much for coming and being with us here today. First of all, tell me about your background. Tell me about Santec.
Well, I'm a civil engineer. I do work designing dams all around the world.
Dams, okay, yeah.
Santec is an engineering and design firm that operates in three different countries.
Yeah, very big, and I know you do some really important work. And of course, when it comes to building dams, the engineering of it is extremely important. And I know that's what you're going to be talking with all the participants about at Girls in Science on Saturday. You're going to be doing two different experiments with them, and you brought one of them here with you today. Tell me what this is all about. What is all this?
Well, dams. Dams, we all know that are extremely important. Dams we use for hydropower purposes, so we can have electricity at home. Mm-hmm. Dams are used for storing water, so we have safe drinking water at home too. So the topic we have chosen to present to the kids on Saturday, it's around dams, and specifically what I'm going to show you today here, it's about the different materials we use to design and build dams.
Yeah, I would imagine something like this probably is not very good, right?
Exactly. Well, it depends. One important thing to know too is that most of the dams in the U.S. are made of either soil or rock fill.
Okay.
So that's why we are going to show them the different materials we use to design and build.
And why you use those specific
materials. And why
materials.
We use.
Okay.
Actually, you can help me with that.
Okay.
Can you?
Yeah, sure. Tell me.
Okay.
I'll do my best.
Well, we have fine soil. We have, you know, some cobbles. We mm-hmm. have some rocks. Mm-hmm. And we have some gabions here.
Now,
and
what
we
are
have
they
clay.
What is this called?
Gabions.
Gabions. Gabions. Okay.
And we have here some clay.
Okay.
So why you don't hold in your hand a little bit of the fine soil and in the other hand a little bit of the clay?
Okay.
And you can tell me what is your reaction here. So what happened when water gets in contact with the two different soils you are holding? Can you see the difference?
Yeah, one definitely holds up a lot better than the other.
Absolutely, right?
Right?
And that's what we do. Dams are designed to hold water.
Sure.
So we utilize different materials so we can hold the water back and we can have safe dams.
That's going to be the material to use. And that's what you're going to be talking to the girls
exactly.
about on Saturday. I know you're going to be there from 9 to 5 on Saturday. We so appreciate you coming to talk with us,
Thank
Carmen.
You.
It's going to be a great day Saturday. No weather excuses, right? The weather's going to be gorgeous, Britt, so you can't use the weather as an excuse for not coming out. We expect thousands and thousands of people, and we hope everybody will come out. Talk to Carmen, learn a little bit more about building dams. It's going to be a great time.
I love the concept of this. Everybody, come on out on Saturday. Ashton, Carmen, thank y'all so much. Girls in Science is Saturday from 9 in the morning until 5 in the afternoon at the Denver Museum of Nature and Science. And you can find all the details at cbsdenver.com. We'll be